Folks, today we're going to talk about critical factors that influence house values. Now, it's not going to be what you normally think. You normally think, well, location, location, location. That's one of them. Yep, that's one of them. The next thing is, how big is the house? Where is it located? What's the amenities around my area? Wonder if I were to say, what really caused or what's causing you guys anxiety when it comes to buying a house? Well, the house prices. Everybody's going to say, well, the house prices have to dramatically crash for house affordability. Well, how about the other component here? How about financing? Mortgage rates went from 2.5% to almost 7.5% within a one-year time frame. We've never seen that in the history of our economy. So what we're going to talk about today is, aka inflation, how these numbers coming in might actually save the housing industry. So let's get to it. The interest rate, unless you have cash, you need to finance a house. So let's take it this way. You're looking to buy a house right now and you're like, I'm in California, starter home's 500 grand. Well, the going rate today, let's say it's 6.5. You can't afford it. Could you afford it at 2.5? Maybe. Well, could that save the market? Well, I got some good news for you. We have some key indicators coming out today and yesterday that showed good signs that inflation's starting to ease. So let's go through the first component. On Wednesday, we had the consumer inflation numbers, and that's right here, okay? The previous number was 0.4. Expectations were 0.4. It came in right at 0.4. The year-over-year number on core inflation, or CPI, consumer inflation numbers, it was the last reading we're seeing right here was 5. Expectations were 5. We came in at 4.9. Now, you might say that's nothing, but it is something, okay? It's starting to come down. So now we fast forward into today's news. In today's news, we have the producer inflation numbers. Look at this number. The previous number of negative 0.4 was basically an anomaly, okay? So let's throw that out with the bathwater. The economists thought it was going to raise by 0.3. It actually eased in and came in at 0.2. So that means inflation in the producer side of the equation and the consumer side of the equation starting to come back down. Now we also see unemployment raising its ugly head because the Federal Reserve says, well, we need more and more people to lose their jobs because a way to cure inflation is for people to have less money. So then they can't buy as much stuff. So what we're seeing on that front is previous reading was 242,000 people filed for first time claims. This time it went all the way up to 264, like I just said. That's a pretty big jump there, folks. Okay. So the next thing is we want to see, is the Federal Reserve going to raise rates at their next meeting? Well, here's the probabilities of that. And the chart is back, folks. Yes, it is back. So let me get my head out of the way. The meeting probability filters, probabilities on future funds on what the Federal Reserve is going to do with the federal funds rate, the rate that they control. So previously we were at 4.75 to 5, which was right here at the May meeting last week. And then they raised rates all the way from 4.75 to 5 to 5 and 5.25. So we are right here right now in that area. Okay. So the probabilities are that we're going to stay right where we are. So that's what's telling you through this level. Okay. So the federal funds rate right now is between 5 and 5.25. And so it's telling us the probability is it's going to stay there for the June meeting. It's going to stay there for the July meeting. And then there's a great chance in September that we're going to actually pivot. The Federal Reserve is going to pivot and start reducing rates. That's what these little blue indicators mean. That's the probability. Do you see how the federal funds rate, it's coming down on the chart? These are rates right through here. This is the probability. So there's a 1.5% probability that in June, the Federal Reserve is going to raise rates again, that we haven't seen that number in a long time. So the probability of future rate increases by the Fed are not there. One big piece of the inflation puzzle that we're going to focus in on is right here. This number is going to reflect, hold on, let me get it for you. This is what's going on with housing shelter numbers, okay? When the Federal Reserve is monitoring the shelter numbers in the CPI, what they do is they look at how much you can get for rent on your house or how much rents are, okay? Their numbers right now that they're watching, and this is proven, everybody keeps saying this, why are they doing this? Is actually right in this range right through here that you're seeing. You can't see it on my screen, but the purple numbers right in 2022. So right through here, mid-year is basically where their numbers are going to be. So right through here, these are where the numbers are the Federal Reserve's watching. Where are the true numbers? Well, they missed this whole decline piece, and now they're up half of where they've been. So when these numbers kick in, you're going to see the inflation numbers basically plummet because these numbers represent a third of the inflation numbers that we watch. Okay, so that's great news on that end. And then the next thing is wholesale prices. Now, this is the piece of the puzzle that came in just today. Wholesale prices rose just 0.2% in April, less than the estimates as inflation eases. So now we're starting to see inflation come down. What all the analysts are expecting is, like I said, right through here, that come the one or two more Fed meetings, the Federal Reserve is going to, well, they're paused now, but they're going to actually pivot. And all this information is providing that those facts for you guys. So if you want to dig in any further on all this, please check out my my channel on YouTube. I have over 2,500 videos. Yep, 2,500 videos to educate you guys on real estate and the economics behind it. So without further ado, what are we looking at today? Well, right through here, this is what's going on in the bond market. This is what I follow on a daily basis. Why? Is because I'm trying to figure out where mortgage rates are going for house affordability for you guys. So what we're seeing on your screen right now is 10-year treasury. Those yields are down 0.07. But here's the two areas that we follow, the MBS markets, MBS 5.5, MBS 5. What the MBS is basically is a mortgage-backed security. That's a bond that trades on Wall Street. That's yield is the biggest component of your mortgage rate. That's why we follow the mortgage-backed security, not treasury yields. Okay. What it's saying right now is the MBS market is up 14. So we're going to probably get a reprieve on interest rates of about 0.05 from where we were yesterday. Now, I'm not going to give you guys rates because rates are totally confusing to everybody because they see them and they say, well, I don't get that rate. My rate's higher than that. Well, it's because you didn't meet those parameters. So if you want to find out what rate you qualify for, all I ask you to do is reach out to us. My name is Dan Frio. I run the rate update. I am a mortgage broker here at Allied First Bank. I have a team of 12 loan officers with me to make sure you guys are supported with your questions and your concerns when it comes to housing. So if you'd like to check out and see how much you would qualify for to get pre-approved, or maybe you're looking into a reverse mortgage or possibly refinancing that house you bought just 6 months ago to 7.5% rate, why don't you look at refinancing maybe to save some money? So to find out more about us, just visit us at therateupdate.com or give us a call at 844-775-5626. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Appreciate it. I'll see you again tomorrow morning. Bye-bye.